there as long as I've been alive.
I saw the frozen tall neck many years before I ever saw a living one.
When the old ones were fresh in their graves and our numbers were still small, it was she who led us through the frozen wastes. We also remember the ravenous tribe who delighted in sucking the marrow from our broken bones. Everywhere Banukai and her Werak fled, the ravenous tribe were never far behind. Seeking a way to defeat them, Banukai went into the wastes and let the wind whip her cheeks. And when the cold brought sleep, she dreamt of light. She saw it behind the world.
Help me out, Zora.
You don't want to end up frozen in the wilds like that tall man.
We'll retake Stone Yield from the bandits before long. One challenge at a time.
Chosen a poor time to visit the cut, Outlander.
I've never traveled around the south.
Tribe killed many, but those in camp rushed to join the battle. They gathered pieces of the fallen machines and from them fashioned weapons. And it was with these that Banukai's people repaid the suck.
Come on. Trust Sakuli's instincts. I've never known one of her paintings to disappoint.
What does the Outlander want?
I'm looking for Sakuli.
You found her. Come, come. Let's get it over with.
Quite a view you've got up here.
It's a useful perspective. How fleeting we are when the world is so wide. From up here, you can see how the light paints across the land. Ever changing. That's a lesson. All our marks will pass.
That outlook sounds a little depressing for a painter.
Haven't met many artists, have you? Song's Edge needs new stories. I scrubbed its past off this rock to start anew. But a new start needs new colors. Fresh pigments, like none have seen.
Aurea said you could help me get the Werax attention.
Aurea works in strange ways. But I've drunk paint to survive in a blizzard, so I'm one to talk. I'll get you noticed, if you bring me the pigments I need to complete my work.
Have you always been a painter?
I've always painted. But I wasn't a painter until I was driven out of Banur. Up there, the markings are eternal. They paint over the same lines, the same colors, over and over. As a child, I learned from copying them. As I grew, my heart sank at the familiarity. All of us Banuk might as well be trapped in glacier ice. We have the look of life, but never really moving.
These pigments you want. Where should I look for them?
Salts gather at the edges of geysers and hot pools. Crystals cling to the rocks and cliffs.
Aurea said you two were friends.
I paint about what I feel now, not the way things used to be. Aurea understood. Most Banuk didn't. I would have been exiled if she hadn't had Aratak take me into their Werak.
The Banuk rock paintings are impressive, but,
You want to know what they mean? That's not the right question, but I'll answer anyway. Some are called to the machines. The sacred shapes you see on metal casings, or on a cauldron door.
Do the machines listen to the call?
I don't know. Others, like mine, are a call to the tribe. You could say inspiration or prophecy. And sometimes even men listen, if the painting is loud enough.
I'll see what I can find for you.
Seek out the vibrant ones. A spring of sudden color among snow or rock or metal. That's its own reward. But I'd reward you as well.
When the old ones were... fresh in their graves, and our numbers were still small. It was she who led us through the frozen wastes. We also... ravenous tribe, who delighted in sucking the marrow from our broken bones.
Every murder.
can't let yourself get complacent.
Override's working. pulse gets some energy, repairs them. Useful. Whoa there! Something tells me those are Berggren's missing hunters. You three know an Osram in Song's Edge called Berggren, do you?
Boys! That con artist sent an errand girl to collect what's owed to him.
I'm nobody's errand girl. Berggren asked me to help harvest parts. Or would you rather keep trying to sell broken junk?
Broken junk?
This pack will be on the move soon. No time to argue. If she's offering to help, we should accept it.
Fine. We're about to take down these machines. If you're so eager to help, then lead the way!
Okay then, let's see if this thing can work for me.
Thank you.
Don't know what business this is of yours, Outlander. All right, Outlander. You want to talk about our deal with Berggrund?
That's done. You three are pretty handy in a fight.
Thanks, I guess. Not that we needed your help. We are doing just fine without you.
That's not the way Berggrund tells it. He says you tried to settle up with him using a shattered Thunderjaw heart.
What? That's an exaggeration. It was only broken in two.
Urkai, we don't have time for this. Come on, boys, back to the hunt. We still need two more of Berggrund's components.
What's the rush?
We want out of these lands as soon as possible. That's all you need to know.
Why are you leaving the Cut?
Well, we could go back to Bal'Nor. Let Anakut slit our throats.
By the blue light, Urkai. Why don't you just write our story in the snow for any passing hunter to read? We had a dispute with the chieftain of our old Werak. We thought someone else should have been in charge. He disagreed.
It seemed like a good time to move on. So, we are traveling to the Sundom.
From here to the Sundom? It's a long trip.
Seems worth it. Sometimes survival is about knowing when to leave and where to go.
Yeah, and in this case, survival means us getting as far away as we can from Bal'Nor. We've seen enough red snow.
What's the plan once you get there? What will survival be about then?
Look. All that matters is that we get there. And to do that, we need shards. So if you'll excuse us.
So this Thunderjaw heart you brought Berggrund...
Let me ask you this, all right? Why would it matter that the heart was broken into two pieces? Can't you just stick it back together?
Of course you can't just stick it back together!
I just... meant...
Oh, I bet that scam artist Osram could! He just wants to send us on another stupid errand!
Oh, he's not so bad. I like Berggrund.
Like him? Tulamot, he sent us out in the snow to nearly die under the feet of a Thunderjaw, and—
Boys, shut up! Ugh! Every time someone brings up that stupid heart.
I've got the Scorcher Claw Berggrund was asking for. That only leaves the Stalker Sinew and the Snap Maw Fang.
You should hold on to it. You're coming along to the next hunt after all, aren't you?
I suppose somebody's gotta keep you three out of trouble.
Fine. I guess you'll have to tag along, then. But don't start thinking you're one of us. The Bloody Snowdrifts aren't accepting new hunters.
Bloody Snowdrifts? That's what you want to call our Werak?
Yeah, it's not great to die.
Well, it's not like your names are any better. You. We're headed northwest, to the ruins near Hollow Hall. We'll be waiting.
Nutritious. Saving these for the trail. Rode right into that. It was that pulse from the tower.
Thank you.
No space. Low and quiet does it. Can stop tensing up.
Cold.
Very cold. I get it. Should have brought a cart. That'll help. There's the herd. Everyone ready?
Are you joking? We were born ready. Let's go get them, Flaming Skulls!
Nope. That's awful.
It is a pretty bad name. Good effort though, Urkai.
Forget it. Let's just go kill something.
Oh!
I don't know about you three, but I feel better. Aloy, did you get that component?
That's another part down. One more and you'll have what you need to pay off Berggrund.
Starting to feel real, you know. I'm starting to believe we're really gonna get out of here. Honestly, I wasn't sure we'd survive a week without Nekoni. But here we are.
Who's Nekoni?
She was a friend of ours. She challenged the chieftain for control of our... of the Werak.
She didn't make it.
No. If you're gonna tell this story, tell it true. She was murdered. Is this...
Onakut knew Nekoni was our mentor. Our friend. We couldn't stay.
That final night, we snuck back to camp, packed what we could, and left.
Like cowards.
What are we to Tai? We are Banuk, aren't we? Survive and prevail. That's what we do.
It's not what she did. Nekoni challenged the chieftain. Why?
Onikup wrapped himself in power and authority the way some people wrap themselves in furs. If you were willing to fawn over him and sing false songs to him, you might get a spot on the best hunts. The Werak split into two. Those willing to lick the bottoms of Onikut's feet, and the rest of us, waiting for things to get better.
Until Nekoni.
She was the best and bravest of us. She was the one who took a stand.
What happened? How did you lose Nekoni?
She challenged the chieftain to a hunting competition. Onikut, damn him! He wasn't nearly the hunter Nekoni was. But who comes back to the camp after the trial? Onikut, grinning like a snap maw, crowing, "Oh, where's little Nekoni?"
We tracked Nekoni through the woods. Found her not far from the trailhead.
Their damn neck snapped.
I don't want to remember her like that. Sometimes that memory, it's all I can think of. I'm sorry, Tai. It sounds like she meant a lot to you. To all of you. I'm sorry for what you've been through.
It's nice to be heard. Thank you, Aloy.
Look, it doesn't matter, okay? What happened in Bonnor is buried in Bonnor. What matters now is what happens in the Sundom. That's where the Burning Turkeys are gonna make a name for ourselves, right?
Oh, the Burning Turkeys? Seriously?
It rolls off the tongue.
Sort of like vomit?
So, where to next?
There's a lake just west of here. Seems like a good place to find a snapmaw fang. We'll meet you there.
If you beat us there, just wait by the campfire. We'll be along.
No sign of me yet. Guess I'll just sit and wait. I was starting to worry about you three. Everything all right?
We took our time. After our last conversation, we had a lot to think about.
I can imagine. Just one more hunt, then your debt is paid and you three can make your way south. Ready?
Huntress, the Sunshine Snowshoes await your signal.
Horrible!
I'm almost impressed, Dulamok. Didn't think you could come up with a name worse than Burning Turkeys.
Well, I liked it. Let's hunt.
I'm in the clear. Keep that for later.
Thank you.
Come here, Aloy. Let's have a proper goodbye, huh?
There. That's the last of Bergren's parts. Looks like you three are out of debt. For now. Until Orkai breaks something else.
It was one time!
You make a nice shaman, Aloy. Thanks for lending a hand. Maybe we'll meet you in the Sundom sometime.
Once you get to the Sundom, what then? What's the next step?
We hunt like Nekoni wanted to hunt.
Nekoni had big dreams. A werak in which everyone pulls their weight and takes care of each other. No shamans, no chieftains, no need to pry the power out of anybody's hands.
Sounds like a lot of work.
But worth it, I think. And a fitting tribute to Nekoni. We can become the werak she always wished for.
You won't have me to strip your kills now. Are you three gonna be all right?
Doesn't look that hard, really. We'll be fine.
Great. He washes three successful harvests and he's suddenly a shaman.
When you get to Song's Edge, talk to Bergrund. If he can't teach you himself, he'll know someone who can.
Sure. And I bet he charges us for the introduction.
Thank you, Aloy. I'm sure we'll figure it out.
I guess this is goodbye. How does it feel, putting Banuk lands behind you?
The only thing I would have missed is already gone.
Let all those rotten Bonor suck-ups freeze to death.
That's a little much, Urkai, don't you think? It's strange. What is it to be Banuk after Banur forsakes you? How do we decide who we are? How about you, Aloy? Who do you think we are? What will you remember of us?
You lost someone you care about. That leaves a wound. The sort of wound a lot of people don't recover from.
Yeah. I've got nothing but scars to show for it.
That's the point. Only survivor scar. After everything you've been through, you keep going.
We're the Scars of the North.
Scars of the North. Sounds pretty tough, doesn't it?
Thank you, Aloy. It's a good name. One we'll honor.
I'd have to ditch something. There's frost between my teeth. Maria said to find her friend, the rock painter. Seems paintings mean a lot to the Banuk. Bergrind, how'd your investment pay out?
Quite handsomely, thanks very much. You know those three crazy Banuk are calling themselves the Scars of the North now? Well, now that I have those parts, I can pay off a debt of my own.
So they've gone south then?
Aye, that they have. I've got a friend in the Sundom by the name of O'Toole. He owes me a favor. Old O'Toole is a machine scavenger. A pretty competent one. So I sent them to learn from the best.
Or at least from the pretty competent.
Well, we work with the resources we have. Speaking of which, here, a token of my gratitude.
I love talking to Sekuli about her painting. I can never make sense of her. May all Stoneheel's bandits freeze in their sleep. A coward's fate. The only one fit for them.